And the more we contribute, the bigger and better it gets.
Absolutely.
I mean it's cool and stuff to work with you this year. I know that you're not going to be able to make it to the banquet for 2016 for Sunset Speedway, but I want to sit there and tell you on how and how much. I mean, we didn't interact much because, of course, you're on one side of the track, I'm on the other side of the track, announcing.
Right.
But everybody, the stuff that you do, Jason, especially on pit exit, I mean, it's I mean, you put yourself in the limelight basically to sit there in, I mean, like Austin Henderson, when he had his crash, it was right in front of you.
Right.
So, I mean, I just want to sit there and tell you how much of an honor to sit there and work with you at Sunset this year, and glad to sit there and talk to you about, Sandlin Speedway.
Absolutely. Yeah, I'm sure we'll be in touch more. We'll be able to get a chance, come on out, check it out, and get some interviews in, and we'll just make it better for the program.
Rob,
Awesome.
buddy, we'll be seeing you soon. Again, we'll have our carts there, and we'll definitely be checking you guys out and keeping people updated what's going on. I want to say thanks for taking your time out tonight to join us here on Northwest Dirt News, man.
No problem, man. Thanks for having me on.
Absolutely, anytime, buddy. We'll talk to you after a bit.
All right. Bye-bye.
See you, bye. So, I mean, it shows right there, and it's good to have a promoter and stuff that wants to come on, promote the track, promote what he's doing. Second year in it. I mean, he's still kind of getting his feet wet, trying to get everything dialed in. But like he said, it's something that, he's excited for and is wanting to, wanting to have more spectators and stuff come out. And that's it. Oh, actually, we're having another caller in.
Actually, this is
Welcome.
Mr. Chris Sine. Welcome to Northwest Dirt News. What's
What?
going on, buddy?
What's happening, you guys?
Man, we're just sitting here in the studio talking racing. Thanks for calling. What's going on? What's on your mind?
I just got done working in the race shop a little bit and was thinking you guys, it's Wednesday night, so I just wanted to call and say hi, see how everyone's doing.
Man, we're doing good. We were just talking before the show went on the air tonight about the the big meeting coming up and then the possibility of this big tour. Let's kind of talk about that. Let's promote that meeting and talk about what you're going to discuss and what people should expect.
Mainly what I'm my goal is to keep the rules really close to what Willamette and Cottage Grove have been running.
Okay.
There's a couple of gray areas that I've seen cars that have been doing things, this and that, and I want to just verify that, some things will be legal and some things won't be. I've got a pretty good set of rules that are more specific than what the tracks have offered already. And like I said, I don't want to change what we got going, but I just want to make sure that everyone's in the same ballpark as what we've been doing.
Now, have you talked? Sorry, Chris.
With all the money that I plan on putting out, and with all the sponsors putting out, I want to make sure that every car is legal when they get paid out at the end of the night, and we'll have good tech guys, and we'll have it to where there's no question about it throughout the night.
So now, have you talked to some of these track promoters, track owners around here, and if you have, what is their feedback on that?
I've got a couple of different feedbacks from a couple of different tracks. Right now, it's looking like it'll be a 7-race series with our local tracks with Banks, Cottage Grove, and Lebanon. And I've been talking to the guys up in St. Helens. I got a guy that's on board up there that wants to add us there, too. It's just real difficult to keep adding more races onto this tour because it pays so much per race to gather up the sponsorship and everything else to do it. If we can do a 7-race series just for this year to see how it happens and see how everything goes and kind of build off of that for the next years.
So definitely baby steps.
Yeah, but I'm talking these will be big paying races.
So, right, well, you're talking about a thousand to win, right?
The minimum.
Yeah, see, and that's what we were talking about that. We were kind of – I know that had been mentioned. We were talking about that before the show started, just amongst us here in the studio. This tour came up, and I thought, man, I have heard – again, we're not going to go on the radio and say, well, this is what we heard, and we want to talk about facts. So you're talking about a minimum of $1,000 to win per event at these street stock tour races.
Yes.
That is phenomenal. Yeah.
So with having this street stock touring event that you want with seven races, is it going to interfere with local track street stock races, or are you going to try to, say if Sunset, because I'm talking about up there, has a street stock race and these guys are running for points, is it going to interfere with any track's point system?
No, because I want to make sure that they're not running their points for that night, because we're going to have a complete separate points for our series.
Which is a great idea.
Good deal.
So,
I want to do a points fund. I want to make it to where top 20 in points will get a decent payout at the end of the year, too.
Well, I think that's going to be easy to do with the – you're going to have – I firmly believe you're going to have 50-plus cars on this deal.
I think so, too. I really – I do think that there's going to be a lot of really good cars. I think the cool thing would be is if we had seven different winners for this series.
Right?
Well, I think it'd be awesome.
That would be awesome.
Well, if to culminate the whole series, the series championship at the Iron Giant, I'm excited to see what happens there.
Yeah. Well, my goal is to do – last year they had the Bobby Morley Memorial.
That was a
thousand to win.
That was the start of our season.
We want to add that as part of our tour.
So okay. So that
I also talked to Nikki about doing the Jim's Thrifty 100 as part of our tour also.
So you're talking about the opener of our season started off with the Bobby Morley. We got rained out, and then of course we pushed it back to the next week. So you're starting. So our start of our season for Sunset Speedway is when you want to start your seven race series, and then midway through the series at our gym's
around 4th of July. Yeah,
our gym's Thriftway 100.
4th of July.
Okay.
And then I also want to include. I guess they're going to do the Clear Cut this year as a street stock race, and that'll be like our mid-season. That'll be a big race there too, and then. We want to do the Iron Giant as a two-day show next year.
So
I like to do two separate races to where it'll be the finale of the deal of the whole series, which will be Labor Day weekend, and it'll be a two-day show, and then we'll crown a champion that weekend.
Wow, that's big stuff.
That's intense. Because if anything goes like what Iron Giant did this year, I'm telling you right now, if you have a two-day show of that.
That's going to be insanely
crazy.
So while we're talking about this, let's talk about the meeting. Let's get the date out there and kind of invite everybody. Hey, if you got some input, if you got something to say, something you want to discuss, you want Chris to know, the meeting's going to be at James Gang Pizza.
Correct. November 4th, which is Friday, and things are going to start around 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock, Friday, November 4th, James Gang Pizza in Lebanon. If you guys have something you want to talk about with Chris, you want to bring something up, you've got questions about rules, that is the time to come in and talk with him and address it and listen to see what he has to say. Chris, you've got a ton of hard work into this thing. I can tell you right now, there's a lot of people, myself included, in the Northwest that really appreciate what you're doing. I know we've had some discussions on the phone, and like I said before, 100%, we will help you do whatever needs to be done on this tour to make it successful. Moxie will back you 100%, and just let us know what we can do to help promote that deal, okay?
Well, I appreciate it. Just give me a little airtime is awesome, and I appreciate everything you guys have done the last couple races for us, too.
Well, you know when we're on, you know where the studio's at. You've been here a half a dozen times. That mic is always free for you.
Absolutely.
Right on. Yeah. One other cool thing is I want to do programs again this year. I want to get all of our sponsors like a full page, if we can do it. I want to sell them at every track that we go to. And I just got some pretty cool ideas. I've already got a couple guys on board who have been actually already making phone calls again, and we'll see what we can do. I want to make it twice as big next year.
Well, I don't think that's going to be hard to do, given what happened last year. It was a pretty spectacular show and absolutely phenomenal, and it was our pleasure to be a part of that, because it was something that I have never seen or experienced before at a racetrack. It was pretty neat.
Well, just the money that was raised and the fan participation in that, I believe the winner, Yak, was you guys even heard it on the backstretch, the fans' participation.
It was incredible.
The pot came in. It was $3,000 to win, and Yak walked out of there with $5,460.
Right.
That's the racing community that we have. Yeah. People just.
Well, I've got a new goal for next year, and I'd like to see 100 cars at that race next year.
I don't doubt that's going to happen. I absolutely can see that. And 100 cars might be, you might be short about 20.
Right.
You know, I can see that. I can see that being a 120 car gig, but. Man, yeah, like I said before, we're going to help out with whatever we can do to get that deal rolling. We appreciate all your hard work and what you're doing for the street stock guys. It's probably my favorite class to watch at any racetrack because it's hardcore racing. And you're a stud, man. We appreciate it. We are up against the clock. It's almost time to get out of the studio. Chris, feel free to call in any time. And again, if we can help, say the word.
All right, guys. Well, I was just thinking of you then, and I just wanted to call and say hi and appreciate everything you guys do. So you guys have a good night, and we'll be talking to you guys all soon.
Thank you, sir.
All right, buddy. Well,
it's a cool dude right
that
there.
That is a cool dude right there.
And to see what he did is doing for the street stocks, you know, your beginner class. It's great to see. I'm glad we can get the support of the racing community behind Chris to make these things happen.
It's nuts. I mean, what that happened to the street stocks and how fast that class is growing. And it's not just how fast the class is growing. It's the level of competition you're seeing in that class.
Well, like we were talking about, is that that's one of our favorite classes of stuff to watch.
Well, it's grassroots racing, but it's still – you still see the speed. You still see them putting doors on each other, and then they're going to go for it. I mean, if they're racing for $200 or $1,000, it doesn't matter to them. It's racing, and they're going to give the fans a show.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Absolutely.
So, guys, it's 3 minutes till the hour. We're going to – you know what? We're just going to call it a night. We're going to get on out from the Jetstream Aqua Massage Studio.
Like this. Warren, did you have a good time?
I had a blast. Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me.
Coming back
no
next
worries,
week.
No worries, Warren.
I'll try to. All right. if we're not working on carts.
Yeah, Yeah, absolutely. So, again, thanks for listening to Northwest Dirt News here from the Jetstream Aqua Massage Studio. Give a shout-out to our sponsors, Northwest Trucking Academy, Crocker's Cars, Tommy's Transmissions, Rugged Radios, Swears Trucking. We've got Holiday Inn Express and CMC. You guys are awesome. We appreciate your support. We will be right back here live next Wednesday night, 6 to 9, on the number one rated Dirt Track Racing Show in the West. I'm Corey Penfold with Josh Warbus, Joel Mamora, and Warren Simpson. We are out. Have a good week.
See you guys.